I sort of see two overreaching problems. We can talk about a lot of the sort of small details that have been facing the city lately, but I think they really come down to two things. One is a lack of direction, which may come from a lack of leadership. It's difficult to get a sense of where the city is headed and what people want to see from their city. We've talked a lot about reducing costs, for example, and keeping a mill rate low is an important part of what goes on in the day-to-day activities of a city, what goes on with taxpayers of a city. However, what that doesn't necessarily do is get you to the end. It's a means to an end. Unfortunately, a lot of times it's been treated as an end itself. So that's certainly something I've been concerned about in trying to focus more on what do we want from Auburn. Because I'm a planner, particularly a transportation planner by profession, those are the kinds of questions I always ask in my job, and those are the kinds of questions I would be asking on the city council. We have some great guiding documents, including the comprehensive plan. I had served on that committee, and I thought there were a lot of great ideas in there. Unfortunately, as of yet, that hasn't seemed to happen. And I would say the other thing related to that is follow-through. A lot of times there are ideas and initiatives that, as they're beginning to get momentum and have an impact on city life, sort of seem to wither on the vine. Anyone can remember back in the 90s we had the ADAPT plan, which really focused on some bringing life to downtown, building new buildings, that type of thing, and that sort of fell by the wayside. There were certainly concerns about spending, but I would certainly argue that we made some investments that have provided returns to the city since then. We need to continue to look at coming up with not only the plans, not only what it is we want for a future Auburn, but making sure that future organizations and bodies are sort of united and come together on making those things happen and following through with them. It's difficult to come as an outsider to a community and sort of see that you're doing a little bit of this, you're doing a little bit of that. It's rather like keeping a house up. If you're halfway done with painting one side of the house and you shingled another part of the roof, the house still looks kind of like a mess, even though you've done a lot of work on it. So from my perspective, unless you have those long-term plans for keeping the house up, it's going to be hard to get people to want to buy.